Looking back on it, maybe if I had gone down a mightily different route, I may have had the opportunity to see the sun again. But what use are hypotheticals to a dead man, eh? To whomever or whatever is reading this, consider it the log of a mad mage. I bid you a good day.
It began much like any other. Punch leaf, punch tree, craft table, pick and axe, fell trees, explore, locate stone, repeat. I need two things to survive, safety and food. These should sustain me for a while. Conventionally, the next step is iron. Instead, I stumbled upon these strange crystals. They're almost electric. Monsters lurk in the dark. Caution is advised. Something's off about this world. I found the forest practically ebbing with the same energy as the crystals. But for now, gravel's a little bit higher on the priority list. Maybe glass. Maybe leather. Sugarcane! You gotta love the stuff. More useful than cactus at least, which I grabbed nonetheless. Daylight isn't infinite. With the sun setting, I have to find shelter from the denizens of the night. Maybe this crack will do nicely. Considering the crystals on the cave wall auspicious, I carved a shelter from the storm out of the rock. From here, I will eke out my meager existence in this world. Like a stubborn weed rooted into the earth, I will suck out its nutrients to sustain myself and defend myself and rest. I awoke from strange dreams to bickering moans. Where is the daylight? Where is the light? The monsters will not spare me for my confusion. And so, I smelted my iron to forge weapons and crafted chests for storage. I want to see the sky for myself. Zombies surrounded the entrance to my home. And when I looked up...
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Zombies descended from footholds in the heavens, but dispatching them gave me a modicum of courage, and so I ventured forth once more for all.
No, you don't.
Unable to kill neither the zombie nor the skeleton, I figured I would focus on my house. It's peaceful here. More zombies than I could handle in a fair fight awaited me at my doorstep. It seems I was lucky in my foolhardiness earlier. Had there been this many laying in wait then, I would be dead without a doubt. Knowledge is power, so I changed my base entrance to avoid an ambush.
What is that? Why does it have camouflage?
The creepers here are a bit different, evidently. Death is certain past the walls of my home.
There are arrow holes in the walls.
I added glass to address the minor issue of spiders and being shot to death before returning to the expansion of my base. I have but two minor issues concerning my continued existence. I don't have a way to get wood. I don't have a way to get food. these can wait for a while. I'm exhausted. So, after killing the mobs at my doorstep, I slept.
Ah, that's an issue.
Two sticks and three iron make a pickaxe. I'm gonna be out of wood sooner or later. There was some iron in my floorboards. Maybe I can make armor.
That'd be nice.
After some more expansion and making a chest plate, I spotted a zombie kitted out in full golden armor. That armor could save my life, so I lured it over before killing it. Where did the armor go?
Food. String. I could make a bow with that.
I used more wood to make pickaxes, and started mining down into the depths in search of resources to make weapons and the dust in my dreams.
Nice.
Despite the lure of resources below, I wasn't reckless. Only after securing my safety did I start my harvest. Redstone, lapis, and gold. With redstone, I could finally make my dream dust. And so I compounded it. Crystalline darkness, air, and order ground the dust by a shard of flint and mixed with redstone in a wooden bowl. I call it Salis Mundus, the unshadowed salt. Maybe rest will give a method to use it. Only sleep can tell the answer. I started the day by descending into the mines and excavating a perimeter to the lava lake. My dreams were returned. It showed me covering a bookshelf in Salis Mundus. A bookshelf requires three components: paper, leather, and wood. I don't have enough sugarcane for all the paper. I used my leather to craft boots, and my wood has been slowly consumed throughout my residence away from the surface. I think wood is the most important of the three. I must ascend. Before I slept, I planted my two carrots in the corner of my room. I walked over to my seeds, made a seat, and sat down. My main issue is food. Without food, I will starve to death in this stone cage. This is the bare minimum. If I have food, I have hope of survival down here. If I do not, I must ascend. My second issue is wood. Without wood, I cannot make the tools that I use to defend myself and mold this world to my advantage. Without wood, I must ascend. And so, today I waited patiently for my crops to grow. Without sunlight, without water, I held on to vain hope that they would grow. The day ended. With it, my wishful thinking. I must ascend. Killing a few of the buggers was a therapeutic way to start the day. Not that it's really much of a day. I've decided to resurface today. Safety procedures are necessary. Full iron armor is the least of them. I started by making a gate above my mineshaft staircase. These trapdoors should have no trouble buying some time in the worst case scenario. I then began my ascent. Another broken axe. I'm almost out of wood. Their baleful moans were deafening. I slabbed the hole to keep out the spiders, expanded, made it a staircase for mobility. I slept. I didn't sleep well. Thinning the hoard with a sword was a futile attempt, so I decided to switch to a lava bucket. That went well. I opened up my hole a little bit more so I could expand. I'm not quite sure what happened there, to be honest. I don't think it knew I could see it. I expanded my little surface foothold into a bubble, so I luckily dug into a surface cave. I don't know where I would be if I hadn't. I went through, filling potholes in the roof and placing lava to avoid a direct confrontation with the monsters.
Where did you come from?
I blocked up the side cave. It seems I had left a pothole unfilled. I quickly remedied that. Blocking off the lower cave entrance was also necessary. It would be troublesome to be ambushed by a spider. By mining select blocks of dirt, I triangulated a nearby tree on the surface and mined out the area under it, before retreating to rest. It's always nice to see the outside world. Despite the risk of a creeper falling on my head, I broke more of the ceiling, replacing dirt with glass until I had located the trunk. I cornered off a little section of the cave before opening up the ceiling to a lava pit trap.
Nothing is coming in.
And just as I thought it wasn't working, I capped off the hole, made it a death trap, and climbed on up. The tree trunk served as the foundation for my expansionist ideology. Lava served as the perfect catalyzer for the monster's deaths. Then I expanded, and I killed, and I expanded, and I killed, expanded, killed, expanded, killed, expanded, killed. I had managed to reclaim a pocket of safety among the savannah. I had managed what I had seen to be impossible. Still, cockiness and arrogance have paved the path of downfall of too many to count. And I didn't want to be lost in the annals of history. My life is precious. And so I retreated, and I lived to see another day. I went back up and continued to expand. It was relatively safe, barring the occasional arrow that snuck in. In a lapse of judgment, I opened up the roof for expansion.
Oh no. Oh no. Oh no 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 no. Oh no 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 no. Please no. Not like this. Not like this.
I filled in that hole. In another lapse of judgment.
Oh come on. Please. Not like this either. Nope, I'm out, goodbye.
After using lava to help me dispatch the zombies, I quickly patched that up. Creepers are gonna be a real problem now, huh?
Ah, that's a bit annoying. Oh, what did you get here?
As it turns out, I didn't quite patch that properly. I'm tired. Time to expand. You'd think I'd know basic safety by now.
Ah, fuck.
You'd be wrong. I mined my first wood today. It's insignificant, but it made me smile in this hellscape. When I made a pit stop at my base, the torches had gone out. If a creeper or two spawned down here, I would be dead. So I spent the rest of the day setting up lava lamps in the walls of my base and my stairs. Then I slept. Lighting logistics are surprisingly exhausting. I darted into the ravine.
Water. Okay. Oh boy, do I have plans for you.
After collecting dirt from the mines, I started construction on a farm. Food is scarce below the surface, and I have to be self-sufficient. There's not really anyone here to rely on. I slept well. You know, it's important to sleep at night.
Hello there.
I needed more wood, so I opened up the roof for expansion.
Oh, come on.
It's gone. With the tree trunk reduced to ashes and only a few blocks above my head, I started construction of the next stage.
Hello.
I started the erection of a tower where that hero stood before going off to make ladders. Up, 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 higher. I didn't know if spiders could climb upside down on blocks, but I wasn't taking any chances. How was I supposed to deal with arrows flying through the fog? I decided to take a risk, then another, slowly and steadily. I constructed my sky base atop a foundation of reckless ambition. Out of curiosity for the ambient cackles echoing throughout my base, I decided to check.
Interesting. Now why don't you dive?
With access to the atmosphere, theoretically, it's possible to grow trees here. Let's test that. Starting the day by expanding is becoming a habit. A creeper blowing the floor from under me would almost certainly spell my death. Luckily, there's an easy solution. I bone mealed my trees for wood. Finally, a sustainable resource. Emboldened by my foray above the surface, I scoured the crag for resources.
Blue ones. Interesting.
I've made ways to get cane and wood. Now, only leather remains.
An idea occurs.
What do you think about it? Leather is just dried cow skin. Following this train of thought, I prepared zombie flesh by compacting it before chucking it in the furnace. Human leather. If you can still fool zombies, humans.
This next experiment seems very, very interesting. What do you do? Amazing. I'm going to need more Salus Mundus.
The first data I gleaned delineated the construction of an arcane workbench. I need water, fire, and earth crystals to progress further. Luckily, blue water crystals were present at the end of the crag, whereas red fire crystals were hanging in the lower caves. Where are the green ones? I searched further into the lower caves. You would think that the scariest thing down here would be the monsters. But no, it's the whispers in the dark. If you strain your ears, you can barely make them out. Bickering. The thought that I'm not alone down here unsettles me on a primal level. Dead end. To the ravine I go.
That doesn't sound good. Water works, okay. Okay. Zombie. by you. Okay, this is survivable. Oh, we're out of food. Okay. Oh! No. Damn it!
Experiences are tiring. Today started with chores. It turns out those exist, even here. I wanted to go back to that ravine, but I also didn't want to die.
Hello again.
The trip was relatively uneventful. Fire crystals, darkness crystals, explore in search of earth crystals.
Why can I hear birds? I am not touching that hornet's nest. No siree. Sleep for me.
If I've remembered correctly.
Perfect. Hello, beastie.
Aw, you didn't have to. Thanks. Before mining the diamonds, I secured the cave and explored the vicinity for an ambush.
Hello. Does your camouflage not work in the light? Nice. You can get 9 veins? Finally.
Greed has been the downfall of too many, so after getting what I wanted, I quickly escaped.
Ooh, gold. Where's the exit? I swear I came from here. No? Down here? No, I swear that I came from up here. Where's the exit? I swear it was like right here.
To progress, now I need glass panes. Do I have any sand?
Oh, you are kidding me.
Now, to get glass panes, I have two options. The first option is to go to a river and harvest some sand. The second option is to use 5 diamonds to make an enchantment table and then craft 15 bookshelves with gold tools to get silk touch at level 18 enchantments before mining my windows. Now, evidently, one of these options is better than the other. I didn't want to interact with the mobs. Now, with my efficiency 1 iron pickaxe, I mined out a separate farm for my sugarcane. I was gonna need a lot of paper, so I remembered and used the most efficient sugarcane farm design that I worked out back in my faction days. Only less efficient than this, which I worked out while writing the script. I then took out my frustrations about my past idiocy on this poor innocent bat. before resting. While waiting for my sugarcane to grow, I explored further into the mines.
That's cool. Sugarcane.
I'm gonna need so many more bookshelves.
Day 19 was spent expanding the platform. After increasing security, I returned.
Okay. How did you get up here? Okay, did you spawn up here? Hello. Die, please. Die. Okay. And die. Alright. Torches.
After expanding a bit more, I made some bookshelves.
Level 18 enchantments. Now I just need to get lucky.
Cycling through my tools and two sets of iron armor didn't get silk touch to show up on the enchantment preview, so I decided to try a different approach. But I needed more levels, so I started construction of an XP farm before retreating. Rest. All of day 21 was spent building the experience farm. The main problem with building this was a lack of safe access to the ground. My first thought was to outline a trough in the air, which I would fill with gravel to stop mobs from accessing the building site. The only problem with this was my severe lack of gravel. So, I decided to use lava as a less solid but much deadlier substitute, using a thin layer of gravel to stop the lava from spreading inwards. Once this was done, the plan was to build a little safety chamber on the ground level and attach it to the top with a pillar, before draining away the lava to allow the mobs to congregate around the chamber and await their deaths. But that was just the plan, and plans do not always go according to plan.
Where are you, Ursh? Okay. Do I? Nah, too valuable. That was close. Okay, I'm calling it a day. Goodbye. Good night.
After making some more food, I resumed work on the mob grinder.
Oh, come on! Now for some initial testing.
fewer than expected. I was wondering about why less mobs were coming in when I realized.
They're attracted to the light.
The distraction was amended before I resumed farming.
Level 18. Moment of truth. Yes!
Infusing a gold rim surrounding a pane of glass with the six primal elements constructed the next step. A tool to see through the veil. But I was tired. Testing could wait until tomorrow. This new invention is amazing. Capable of analysing the essential makeup of the world around me. That is, by the way, the word I've been using to describe the fundamental building blocks of this world. Essentia.
You can fit through that hole?
I've now analysed everything I can get my hands on, including the monsters. I've derived inspiration from those witches. By coating a cauldron in Salus Mundus, I've constructed a crucible, the first step of the alchemical path of magic. The book has a basic alchemical recipe for divine lighting. I simply need essentia for earth, energy and light, along with a glowing powder from hell.
Why is there blueprints for a portal to hell? Why am I doing this? Fine. Okay, not my ideal holiday location. Aye, that's all. Oh, that's fast. What is that? Who made that? Alright. That. Hello. Do you want to kill me? No. Okay, that's good. Hello. Why are you screaming? I'm out. Goodbye. This place sucks. I'm gone. Good man. What is that? Don't care. Never coming back here. Goodbye. Safe. Okay.
After making sure whatever that was couldn't come back the way I came, locking the doors for peace of mind, I took my first step in alchemy.
It's beautiful. Truly, the lighting of the gods.
Superior to lava in application, and to torches in longevity. I did the next logical step of mass production, before upgrading my base's lighting and returning to my studies. The next chapter of the book was titled Alchemical Metallurgy. By infusing instrument essentia into an iron ingot, alchemical brass is produced.
I wonder what else I could mix with iron. Magic!
What if I infused magic? With Earth Essentia as the binder, Salus Mundus providing magic Essentia, and an iron ingot as the catalyst, I made it. The world calls it Thormium.
What can I do with you?
I crafted it into a helmet. Functionality is better than iron and worse than diamond. But I don't have any diamonds. I started production of Salus Mundus en masse. It was easily the rarest thing in the recipe, before splitting my reactants into three separate batches. Mass production then began.
More than enough. What are you?
Armor, tools, and weapons were made and enchanted. Its affinity for enchantment rivals gold.
This should help me survive a bit longer.
After scanning, I shifted focus from alchemy to infusion. To progress further down the alchemical path, I would need to create my own theories. And I was lacking the two vital components. There were notes in the book for a magic fabric, which, when constructed into a robe, enhances mana efficiency. I could only make one cloth with my available resources. Progress in this path was halted as well. There was one path left in the book's notes. Artifice. By bonding two thermometers together with alchemical brass and leather, it's possible to create goggles that peer into the mana flows of the world. I would need more ore for the thermometers, so I decided to have a quick mine before sleeping.
The torches are out. Oh, why don't you have eyes?
I managed to scan a creeper. Not animals. The readings show a combination of fire and plant essentia. How is that even possible? I found a vein of gold under a lava lake on the dawn of day 26. I really should have slept before coming here.
come out wherever you are. There we go. I always wanted more iron. Two. Oh, never mind. Thank you. You gotta love white crystals. I wonder how they turned into crystals. I really hate these sections with multiple entrances. You never know which way death is approaching you from. Ooh, yellow crystals. More gold, yay. Hello. Where are you? Nope, not getting ambushed today. Into the lava you go. I really hate these sections. Okay. Like a lot. Like a lot, a lot. Green crystals, thank you, water. Oh, come on, insert golden shower joke. Water is so annoying. At least it looks nice. How do I get out of here? This way? 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 Gotcha. Home sweet home. I am so tired.
After making another silk touch tool and making a gold clad skeleton, I mined some windows and finally made my thermometers before strapping them together into crosses of revealing. Really enhances the mad scientist vibe, and although it took a little tinkering, I managed to fit them inside my helmet. To progress further on the path of artifice, I need not only theoretical knowledge, but also greatwood, of which I have the resources for neither. After a quick patrol to keep the lights on, I went to sleep. Those consecutive all-nighters hit my sleep schedule hard. Further progress is impossible without both ink sacks and feathers, and difficult without greatwood or wall. To find any of these, I need the ability to see far away into the dark. This way, I can meet my first objective, locate an ocean or river for ink. Now, the simplest way to go about this is a flame bow, allowing me to shoot light sources into the distance and scope out my surroundings.
Okay, hello there. I was just thinking about rabbit stew. Can you die for me, please? Oh, that's not good. Okay, I can fix this. I just need none of you to come in. Okay. No. Good as new. Infinity.
God damn it. After cycling through the enchantment previews a few times, I gave up on wasting levels and returned to farming.
Level 20, yay. Maps. Why didn't I think of maps?
Constructing a compass and surrounding it in paper yielded me a map, a pre-generated bird's eye view of the surrounding area.
I know where the ocean is.
I started construction of a tunnel to the ocean, passing through the ravine and using lava as lighting. I fell short of reaching the start of the water before I grew tired and slept. Continuing my tunnel, I started mining up, intending to surface from the ocean floor.
Why can I hear you? I should not be able to hear you. Why is there an island here?
I detoured left, towards the ocean.
Sand? No water. Beach. That's a lot of mobs.
After dealing with my mob issue and making my way to the edge of the ocean, I withdrew from my tunnel and went to sleep. I made my way down to the tunnel, serenaded by the birds.
Wait, birds aren't-
Surfacing my tunnel by the beach would be a fool's errand, so I expanded out to the sea. The only problem with this, of course, was the dark expanse of the ocean. If I'm not careful, I could accidentally block my way in and drown. I'm still not quite sure how it happened, but...
God, that's cold. I did not mean to come up here. Might as well clean up.
After that event, I figured I was far enough away from the shore to surface. And so I started constructing a pillar up to the surface.
Rain. I never knew the feel of rain could be nostalgic. Ah.
I'd been growing complacent. I have to thank that skeleton for its ambush. It served as a grim reminder that nowhere is safe. I cannot grow complacent in my position. If I do, only death awaits me, as it has so many others. But now is not time to worry. It's time to rest. I continued expanding the outpost, increasing its diameter, and placing glass tubes.
What? How is that possible?
The fog disappears through the glass. I was quick to apply this discovery and investigate the surroundings of my base, locating a desert to the east, and what looks like the outskirts to the Essentia Forest, far to the north. Unable to find any chickens in the local area, I resumed work on the ocean outpost, and ventured into the ocean in search of squid. After crafting a work table and glass bottles, all I was missing with my newly acquired ink sacks was feathers. The only way to get feathers is through parrots, or chickens, and with no jungle or chickens in sight, I was going to have to get creative. Avoiding mobs was a necessity, so in order to get feathers, I would bridge across the world until I stumbled across a chicken, before fishing it up to slaughter. But before preparing for any expedition, testing the veracity of my plan is necessary.
Can I do it a little higher? Maybe. Okay. Oh, that's a lot of feet. That is not good. Okay.
No, please no. Okay, that's not happening. Okay. I'm alive. Okay, tree. Tower is a safety. Okay, I'm safe. Light is a terrible idea here. Okay. Healing skirt. Visibility's terrible. Okay. Alright. We can just tower. Spider. Okay. Are you coming up? You are. Okay, please. Just die. Are you coming? It's dead. Okay, that's good. Okay. We tower. Okay. Where are the papers? Glass, okay, I have glass. So I've got a spider. That's a spider. Okay, that's not good. Creepers, are there any creepers? Okay, please die. Okay then. Are you coming? Spider, are you coming? Spider, where are you? Okay. It's not safe. I'm just going. Trees are good. Bridge. I did not want to be followed back through this way. Alright, I'm safe? Alright. Okay. Do not want anything coming back this way. Anything at all. I'm safe. Alright. that just happened.
Shaken from my exploits away from the base, I slept, thoughts racing through my head. I decided to descend into the mineshafts. Acquiring wealth served to be a good backdrop to my schemes. I would need to chart my course if I were to. I created a larger map and patrolled my base to fill it in.
I knew one of you would show up there.
With my map as filled in as I could get it, I rested. My life will always be the most important thing during to safeguard it, I will need numerous contingencies and preventative measures. With my resources organized, I began strip mining into the earth in search of the miners.
Perfect.
With the first step complete, I slept. I figured I would need it. After taking care of the ambient creepers, I started grinding for my first 30th level enchantment. As it turns out, the purple men dislike eye contact.
No pearls. Damn it. Level 30. Finally.
After a short nap, I upgraded my enchantment area. With nothing good when cycling through my diamond gears previews, I enchanted an iron pickaxe.
Fortune! Nice.
I quickly made my way back down to my diamonds, mining all the ore present on the way.
16, more than enough. Actually, I've gotten quite a bit of experience from mining.
So, for my next level 30, I started strip mining instead of visiting my grinder.
There we go. Still none? There we go. Hello, spider. Can you get off the hide? Be annoying, aren't you? Please die. What? Oh, no. Do I have blocks? No. Okay, cobblestone. Okay, please let me place. Just let me place it down, please. No. Okay.
I am so glad that there are invincibility frames in login.
Why can you climb ladders?
After enchanting some more diamond gear, I slept again. All of day 39 and the start of day 40 was spent finishing off my set of diamond gear. With the minimum preventative measure in place, I could start my other preparations for it. And as I was making my way back to the XP grinder...
What is that? What are you? Are you an entity? I need to be more careful.
Overcome by curiosity, I decided to venture into the Knight's Domain and investigate.
What are you?
After collecting my readings, I was forced to hastily retreat. The monsters do not tolerate unwanted intruders. After coming home, I analyzed my readings. It seems impossible, but it was a tear in the fabric of space, caused by an overflux of ambient inertia in the atmosphere. Theoretically, it should be possible to use the tear to travel between worlds, but in practice, the unstable space will dismantle incoming matter to the subatomic level.
I finally see hope of returning to.
With diamond armor as the foundation, golden carrots and apples will serve as supplements to my survival. With torches, I can ward off the monsters that depend on the dark. A compass can guide me home from far-off lands. An obsidian portal can save me from termination in the absolute worst-case scenario. With my contingency plans ready for action, I rested. I would need it. I don't know when I can next sleep in a bed. To progress further, I need greatwood, chickens, and knowledge. With the fruit of my work, I was prepared to set out into the unknown. My first objective was the northern essential forest. There should be great wood there, and with no fixed location for chickens, a tangible goal was best. I encountered the balls of light again. On closer inspection, it turns out they're just spheres of compressed essentia.
How interesting.
Where is the grape?
Ah, no you don't.
Escalating the forest through the treetops, it wasn't long before I found great wood. 64 logs and 4 saplings should be adequate.
Ah, goddammit, shield. Okay. That is a few mobs. Alright. Goddammit, skeleton. Okay, into the river.
After returning to the forest, I collected silverwood saplings and briefly explored the treetops. With my goal here now complete, I set out to fill my map. There is no time or place to rest in the wilds. Dry acacia slowly transitioned into arid desert. After fixing my sand shortage, I harvested the fire plants native to this area. Its flower sparks with a faint flickering light. I think I'll call it
cinder blossom.
With reduced visibility from the fog, accidents were bound to happen.
Sunflower, huh?
But where is your sun? The great plains melted into deserts before plains again, and water and rain. With visibility low and torchlight fading, exploration in the dark would be equivalent to suicide. With fortifications from the arachnids and a roof over my head, this world's wilds were sprawled out before me.
The sun beyond the horizon glowed. The yellow river seaward flowed. A solitary shadow flowed. The misty rain is far away. How many has it washed away?
When I awoke, the storm had subsided and the visibility was as high as it was going to get. After planting a marker, I checked my course and set out.
Thank you for your sacrifice.
Every ender pearl was a potential lifeline.
Shush. Finally, feathers. What are you?
As it turns out, letting your guard down isn't the best idea.
Out of the way. Hello there.
While travelling the world, using a map is difficult without an adequate light source. With the plains entrenched in rain once more, I would need to find shelter to weather the storm. And quickly.
Wait, the lights are on? Empty. Please be alive, please be alive. What are you doing out in the rain?
With the hostile mob's ongoing siege, this village will fall sooner rather than later. Their current existence in itself is already a miracle, given their lackluster defenses.
What are you doing, you idiot? You too?
With freedom, these villagers will die. Constructing cubic prison cells will keep them safe. I'm sure they'll understand when they're older.
Ah! Okay, hello. I didn't mean to insert myself into your party here. I'm just going to go. I'm just gonna leave. Enjoy yourselves. Oh, come on. That looks safe. Hello.
With walls around me and a roof over my head, I organized my inventory before making a chair and sitting down. I've done all that I can for these people. Maybe I can take care of them in the future. By the time I awoke, the storm had subsided again. So, out into the world I went once more.
A church. Huh.
With the unending horde of zombies, the priest's offer of flesh for emeralds could be invaluable. Though, I wonder where they get their emeralds from. After checking my course and collecting my bearings, I set out south through the village and into the wilds. With the bottom left corner reached, I headed east to fill in the bottom border.
Serene. I wonder what lurks in those inky depths.
With land in sight, I turned around and continued documentation of the ocean's domain on my map. Northwestern quadrant filled, I travelled down to complete my southwestern border, sailing inland through the arterial rivers that power this cursed land.
Oh, come on. I like the boat. The boat is safe.
Nothing bad ever happens while exploring the wilds.
I am so glad that I have protection on my boots. Southwest is complete.
So I headed to fill in the gaps in my borders. Tired from my journey, I figured I would make a place to rest before heading home. So, I started looking for a suitable hill for construction. Foundation carved out. I rested. Thank you. bones of the dead. I made myself a chair, sat down, and slept.
I'm going home tomorrow.
What in the name of... I've been working on this project since it should be March 15th. It's currently May 20th. It's been a bit over 2 months. This has been the majority of my life for these about 2 months. Thank you for watching to this part. And yeah, why would you stay for this long? It's about 2 a.m. I have my GCSEs in
six-ish hours. Yeah. Please subscribe. It's probably worth it if you've made it to this and you're still listening to me. I still don't... Why? Why would you do that? Anyways, yeah. Subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you. Genuinely. Thanks.